What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Shuggy from Shook Earth Media, and today we're talking about Walking Dead Deluxe. Now, as you guys know, huge Walking Dead fan, despite the fact I've been critical of the TV series lately, the comics, absolutely flawless. I wish I was reviewing them as they came out, but it would have just been like, oh, I love this issue, and I love this issue, and I love this. It wouldn't have been a lot to analyze necessarily, so just suffice it to say, love this comic series. It's my favorite comic series of all time. So, for those who don't know, The Walking Dead, when it came out originally, was in black and white. There was no color at all. And after it was over, Robert Kirkman, the writer, creator of The Walking Dead, announced that it would be re-released on an issue-by-issue basis in comic stores in color. Now, my first reaction, as you guys know, I'm a skeptic by nature. My first reaction was one of skepticism. I was like, is this really necessary? I thought that the play on light and in the black and white and the shadows and the shading, especially when Charlie Adlard was doing it himself, was just so striking. I was very hesitant to jump on board. I was like, I'll buy the first issue just to see how it is, but I'm not so sure about this whole Walking Dead Deluxe thing. I was so wrong. And I'm here to admit that I was completely wrong in my original feelings, and that In Color is without a doubt way better. It is without a doubt the ultimate way to view The Walking Dead. And the fact is that black and white was a barrier for many people getting into the series in comic form, especially on television. It's in color. Seeing it in black and white and on paper, it's a little bit harder for people to get into. I mean, the color is just so striking. It makes it much more immersive. And that's where it comes down to being better, honestly, is the fact that you get a whole lot more information than you really think from color in the comic format. You get time of day, you get lighting, as in, like, say they're around a campfire. You see the campfire in the wide shot, but on these tighter shots, you might lose track of the fact that there's a fire there, whereas in color, you can see the light playing on their face from the fire. You can see the backdrop with the darkness in this dark blue. You can see all of that without needing to be reminded of it. And even though, of course, you're able to keep all of this in mind reading it in black and white, just seeing it in color on a panel-to-panel basis, it brings so much more life to the series. It makes it so much more immersive and atmospheric, and it just is without a doubt way better. Now, another example is there's a lot of close-ups in these books because there's a lot of dialogue. It's a drama, first and foremost, so we have a lot of people talking about stuff. And I'll be putting B-roll with examples and such, but you can see the coloration of the backdrop, which would be just white or grayish or maybe shadowed in some way. But in some of these close-ups in color, the color changes depending on the emotion of the character. So it'll go from being like this olive green to this yellow to red as it goes from a calm character to an enraged character, and the subtle transition in between. So it's so much more immersive. It really just brings out the emotions of each character, and everything just pops so much more. I mean, in this prison arc especially, you see all the characters in orange jumpsuits. They just pop off the screen. As you can see, just so much more visceral with the color, especially when it comes to the gore. The blood just pops out so much, and you can really distinguish a lot more details than you could before, even though the details were in there before. Just the fact that it's in color makes it easier to tell what is what, and as a result, the image is just overall more affecting. You don't notice it at first, but you see the emotion so much more, even just having the face in color and everything like that. Like, the mood of the scene is set by the lighting. So even though, like I said, you can tell time of day based on the color, but more than that, you can set the tone based on what type of day it is. Is it an overcast day? Is it a sunny day? Is it somewhere in between? Is it this sunset where you get this orangey glow to everything? Is it colored more like a Western and it's a lot of tans and greens and stuff like that and beiges? There's so much information that you don't even really think about being in color when you see it in black and white. And I'm still a big fan of the shading and how Charlie did all of that in black and white. And ultimately in black and white was still a great way to read it. But seeing it in color now, it's just so obvious that this is the ultimate way to see this comic. And if you haven't read it yet, now is the best time ever to jump in. They're releasing these twice a month at comic stores, and you can support your local comic store and stuff like that, and that's all great. I believe it's available digitally. I'm not entirely sure about that, actually. I'll correct myself in editing if I'm wrong about that. I highly recommend it if you're a Walking Dead fan. It's a great time to jump back in and fall in love with these issues again. Rereading the story, reminding myself of some of those finer details I had forgotten over the years. It just really brings home the fact that this series is so great and the pacing is so brisk and there's so much going on and so much under the surface and the drama is just very, very compelling. So it's even better than I remember it being, and the fact that it's already one of my favorite comic series ever. It is my favorite comic series ever. So just reminding myself of that has been really great, especially since I've been critical of the show lately, as I mentioned. So it's been really great to bring myself back to the roots of why I love the series so much. So I do highly recommend Walking Dead Deluxe. And with that, I will bid you guys adieu. We'll be back with more content every day this week, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out, everybody.